Alright, I am back. Ooh, it's a bit chilly out right now, that's why I have the heater on. But, yeah. So, people have probably noticed I'm uploading this on weekends for now. That's just until everything gets caught up. Since I have a few months already lined up worth of stuff. I even think I have Fallout 76 set up yet. So, yeah, I've also recorded like three games since then too, so yeah. Otherwise I'm gonna go ahead and continue and then gonna mute myself.
Revelio. I know what that means. Merlin trial. Revelio. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Wingardium Leviosa.
Has your brain been infected with Bundaman? A maneuver like that could have got us killed.
Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Lumos. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Wingardium Leviosa. Confringo. Wingardium Leviosa. Flipendo. Wingardium Leviosa. Flipendo. Wingardium Leviosa. Flipendo. Lumos. Flipendo. Wingardium Leviosa. Flipendo. Wingardium Leviosa. Flipendo. Wingardium Leviosa. Accio. Flipendo. Revelio. Revelio. Accio. Revelio.
More times than I can count. They're incapable of defending themselves. What was that? Lower Hogsfield needs them.
Perhaps it's dinner I'm hearing.
Flipendo! Confringo!
You're going to regret that!
Accio! Flipendo!
Please stop!
Confringo! this be Mr. Oakes's campsite?
And while here...
Akio! Confringo! Glacius!
I won't rest until you're dead.
No!
I will make
Revelio. Confringo. Revelio.
Mr. Oakes' trade journal.
Revelio. Confringo. Confringo. Glacius.
Adelaide said that her uncle kept notes of his trades, maps. Perhaps these landmarks will lead me to him.
Revelio.
What do we have here?
Revelio. Accio.
Troubled. I may have more luck higher up in the keep.
Confringo!
Kill spells glance off of me. Boom! That was meant for me.
Glacier!
But then surrender.
Confringo!
Stone walls do a prison make, sometimes.
Revelio. Confringo.
A ladder. That's what I need.
You call that spell?
I won't.
You're dead.
Revelio.
Ah, there you are.
Confringo!
Why have you not run away? Intend to die, do you?
This is the spot on the map. I'd best have my wits about me.
One less human to
work. Glacier! Confringo! Revelio.
Lumos.
What will we find in here?
Accio!
It's punishment to us all to have that miserable human around.
Confringo! Glacier!
I won't rest.
Accio.
It looks as though Adelaide's instincts were spot on.
You only have Ranrok to blame.
Revelio. Revelio. Accio.
No! I will...
Revelio.
The metal we were promised.
places. Confringo. Ranrok has fooled you all to your demise. Revelio. Confringo. Revelio. I need to find Mr. Oakes's wand. Where could it be? A boiler door. How to open it? Lumos. Revelio.
Confringo!
No!
I will make you.
Confirm that.
Was that your plan? You won't stop me. I've been fighting since before you were born.
Confringo!
I won't rest until...
Please, your spell glance off of me.
Confringo! Confringo!
Losing your stride.
I shall avenge your death.
Place it. Confringo!
Get away with that. You won't defeat us all!
Rebellion. This must be Mr. Oakes's wand. Perhaps now he can set himself free.
And wait, you're a student? Oh, we must get you to safety immediately. It's dangerous.
It's all right, Mr. Oakes. I've dealt with these goblins before.
Dear Merlin, you're either very lucky or very talented. How did you find me?
I'm a friend of Adelaide's. She was worried about your business with Ranrock's loyalists.
Oh, she was right to be. I couldn't go through with the agreement, and when I told them, I ended up blindfolded and behind bars. Been locked in that infernal cell for so long, they'd forgot I was even there. I overheard things. If only I could reward you for what you've done. Blasted goblins stole every canut on me. All I can say is thank you, truly.
You mentioned you overheard things.
Sad tale, really. I think I know where Ramrock's unfortunate vendetta against wizardkind began. Although dragon breeding was outlawed by the Warlocks' Convention of 1709, Ranrock stumbled upon an illegal dragon camp. He was young, found the creatures fascinating. He'd visit the camp in secret whenever he could, never making his presence known. After weeks of sly surveillance, he finally summoned the courage to speak to the wizard in charge. Ranrock wanted to join them and the creatures. The wizard happened to drop his wand. Ranrock saw an opportunity. He picked it up, went to hand it back as a means of introducing himself. The sight of a goblin with a wand sent the wizard into an instant rage. He beat Ranrock nearly to death. Ever since, Ranrock has despised wizardkind, sees us all as cruel.
Am I right that you speak gobbledygook?
Unbeknownst to Ranrock's fiends, I do. I've always had an affinity for goblin culture. Knew I wanted to be a metal trader ever since I was a lad. It wasn't easy learning the language. It's complex, and my memory's as weak as my knees these days. But after decades working with fine goblin folk, I grew fairly proficient. At least, I'd like to think so.
I'm grateful I was able to help you, Mr. Oakes. Adelaide thinks the world of you.
Oh, and I her. She's become quite savvy to my trading habits, always analysing my detailed owls. Oh, if only I hadn't resorted to trading with such fiends. A lesson I shan't soon forget. Having my wand back is like being reunited with an old friend. I must return home and inform Adelaide of my safety. Will you be all right?
I'll be fine, Mr. Oakes. You get back to Adelaide. I assure you, her worries outweigh yours.
Oh, I'm anxious to see my dear niece. And then I plan to travel far from here for my next round of trading. Thank you. May life reward you justly for your deeds. Be well, my friend.
Rebellion!
Mr. Oakes was lucky. Ranrock's lot would never have freed him.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Your blood's on Ranrock's hands. Revelio.
Now before we find another repository.
How nice of you to stop by.
Confringo!
I will make you.
There's the student from the town. Up for a bit of dying, are we?
You won't get to stop that
Revelio.
Thank you.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Confringo. Lumos. Arresto momentum. Incendio. Thank you. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Thank you again for delivering those potions to Madame Lawing. Saved me a lot of time and trouble.
I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Sorry if there's a smell. New batch of toad hide. You could never go wrong with those. Good choice, I'd say. You could never go wrong with those. Good choice, I'd say. You could never go wrong with those. Good choice, I'd say. I'll not mind seeing you here again. Consider yourself welcome.
Care enough to remove my demigod statues.
Pardon me, sir, but about those curious demigod statues I've seen.
What? Who are you? Why do you ask?
They're quite clever.
Oh, thank you. A lot of craftsmanship and care went into them, I assume.
So you did create them?
Yes, I did. It was a ploy to give that pathetic oaf Moon a taste of the grief he caused me years ago. You are the one who's been pilfering them.
I am, at the request of Mr. Moon. I received your owl on your stationery.
Ah, well, fitting Moon would enlist a student. Too cowardly to do it himself. Hasn't changed a bit. Even when we were at school, he was a cowardly bully. Gave me a horrible nickname, which I shan't repeat. I was thrilled when we left school and he seemed gone for good. Then I started seeing him around Hogsmeade. It was too much. Even if I do take satisfaction in that his life's destiny was to be a lowly caretaker.
Mr. Moon does a good deal for the school, and he's taught me a lot. He's terrified of those statues.
I know. You should have seen his face when that boggart appeared. Oh, priceless. That's when I knew what I needed to do. I simply didn't want to encounter him anymore. So, I shrewdly put a boggart in his path to learn his greatest fear. I then created the demigod statues to keep him in his place, so to speak. The Moons were inspired to play on his name. It worked brilliantly. Until you started clearing them out.
Sounds as if Mr. Moon deserved what he got. But perhaps it's time you both moved on.
Fair point, I suppose. If they've terrified him, as you say, he may have learned his lesson.
Alright. So it looks like it'll be up for me today. But yeah. We'll see where it leads tomorrow, or whenever I decide to record. So yeah. Peace out.